Our project is sound alert system for hearing impaired people. This project is done in assistive technology lab in Sri Vishnu Engineering College for Women in technical collaboration with University of Massachusetts, Lowell, USA, under the guidance of Mr. VSR Pavan Kumar. Blindness separates people from things, but deafness separates people from people, says Helen Keller. These are not just her words, but her experience and her pain. Not only hers, but of 800 million people, that is over 11% of the world population who has disabling hearing loss. Out of them, 80% live in low and middle income countries. The hearing impaired live in a silent world where they blend into the background and are often ignored or cast aside as second-class citizens. If they have to move in traffic without fear, they depend on someone else, as they couldn't hear the horn sounds. They communicate through sign language, but if they had to call someone else, they couldn't do that unless they are in a distance reachable by hand. All this is just because they cannot hear any sound. How would it be if they are able to recognize horn sounds or respond when someone is calling him? They need not depend on others for anything. They become independent and confident. This can be done by a sound alert system. Our objective is to enable the hearing impaired people to recognize the horn sound of the vehicle and to make the interaction of the hearing and speech impaired people easy with people having similar disabilities. This is how the sound alert system looks. It is actually a wristwatch that can work in two modes, namely traffic mode and interaction mode. Required mode can be selected using the mode selection switch. In traffic mode, the watch vibrates if there is a horn sound, and in the interaction mode, the number key can be used to call other person, and the watch vibrates if someone is trying to call the user and displays the number who is calling him. What all is required to realize this device? To implement the traffic mode, a microphone is required to convert the input sound into the electrical signal. In case of using a microphone, noise comes into picture for sure. Filter should be used to eliminate this noise. A microcontroller to compare input voltage levels that comes from the microphone with fixed threshold level and activate the output terminal. A vibration motor to alert the user. Coming to the interaction mode, when a number is pressed, this information must be transmitted to the other device, and when some other transmitter transmits a signal for this particular device, it is to be received. So, transmitter and receiver are required. Switches should be placed to call other people. When a signal is received, the vibrator should be activated and the sender's information is to be displayed on the LCD. Microcontroller performs this operation to alert the user that someone is calling him or her. Micro vibration motor is required. LCD unit is required to show him who is calling. Microcontroller. The microcontroller we are using is MSP430G2553. Based on the actions to be performed, some features are must for the microcontroller we use. Comparator is required to compare the analog signal, that is the signal output of the microcontroller, with the fixed threshold. And universal serial communication interface. This is required for the interaction mode. Filter. The filter is required to eliminate the noise. To allow a particular band of frequencies and reject all the other frequencies, bandpass filter must be used. The bandpass filter is designed with the following specifications. This is because all the horn sounds are usually in the range of 600 Hz to 3000 Hz. This is the output of the filter. The orange line is the output signal from the microphone, and the blue line is the output of the filter. The output of the filter is fed to the amplifier. Here, the orange line shows the output of the filter, and the blue line shows the output of the amplifier. The transmitter and receiver we are using is RF 434 megahertz transmitter and receiver pair. The transmitter we select must have high data rate and reliability. So we have selected this RF 434 megahertz transmitter and receiver because they have high data rate of 4800 bits per second, 500 feet range, but only in perfect condition. However, they give up to 100 feet range in normal condition. This is the data output of the transmitter. This is the waveform at the data input to the receiver. Encoder and decoder. The encoder and decoder we are using are HD12E and HD12D. These are selected because of their wide operating voltage range from 2.4 volts to 12 volts. Their interface with RF is very easy and they require minimal components. This is the sound alert system that we have implemented. This is the power button. Now, the device is in traffic mode. Now, when I give a horn sound, the device is vibrating. This is the functionality in the traffic mode. Now, if we want to switch the device into the interaction mode, we can use this mode selection switch. Now it is in the interaction mode. Now I'm switching on the other device, which is also a sound alert system. This is already in the interaction mode. Now, if that person wants to call the other person, then he will press the number key corresponding to that one. Now this device is vibrating and showing in the display that one is calling him.
హార్న్ వేస్తాడు కదా, అప్పుడు మీకు ఇక్కడ తెలుస్తుంది అన్నమాట, అప్పుడు పక్కకు వెళ్తారు. నెక్స్ట్ ఇంకోటి ఏంటంటే
థ్యాంక్ యూ ఫర్ యువర్ వాల్యూ.